Hello guys, today we're gonna sharpen one knife. It calls Fishman. The steel is X50 Sear MVO15. It looks like the same steel as for Global knives. It's this knife has a length about 20 centimeters. It's a slicer knife, but you also can use it for deboning the fish and to cut some products, actually, kind of universal knife in the kitchen. So the edge is not so damaged, just need to adjust a little bit. Okay. So I'm gonna show you how is it cutting at the moment. It cuts, but really, really, really bad. So, we're gonna do some magic. See? Alright, so we're gonna do some magic and we're gonna sharpen this knife. So here I got a plain water. The stone was before in the water for like 10 minutes. And this is stone number 1000. So gonna start with that, and then you're gonna use stone number 3000 and then the leather stock. So let's start. The edge I'm gonna keep about 15 degrees. To be honest, this is not my favorite type of the knife to sharpen. I prefer more Santoku or chef knife. But I'll do everything what I can to bring this knife back to life. For me it's much more easier to sharpen the Santoku or chef knife. I don't know, it feels like this is a little bit different. Let's go for another side. A little bit more water. Alright, let's see. Need a little bit more of this side. And let's finish a little bit more here. Okay. So let's do a small test with the paper. All right, not bad. So now we can go on the stone number 3000. So this is a stone number 3000 and we are continuing sharpening the knife. All right, let's go. Just a second. All right. So let's go. Not very comfortable to hold it. German knife is always difficult to sharpen because of this part. So when you're sharpening, you're always kind of touching it and you're cutting a little bit away material from here. So you need to be very careful to not damage the knife. Alright, then we're going to the other side. A little bit more water. Slowly moving closer to tip, this part. Okay. So let's see what is happening now in our knife. Very difficult to fix there, so you can see it. Well, doesn't matter. Let's try it out on the paper. And it was really nice and smooth. So let's finish it on the leather stroke. Here is my favorite leather stroke. Different grits, so it's all leather, but in here a different paste. So number one rough, number two like medium, number three green paste, like everybody knows, that's like a fine, and number four is super fine. So we're gonna start with number two first, and then going through the number three to the green one. So here you have to do the moves opposite from the blade. So if this is a blade, you cannot do the moves like that. You can only do the moves opposite from the blade, and the same from other side, like that. But if you do like this, you're gonna cut the leather stroke. So let's go, one side, another side, one side, another side. I'm gonna do the leather stroke for few minutes. Usually it's more than enough. And cutting edge gonna be really shiny, and you're removing all the barrels or bars. Not sure how is it correct. So the blade is, you like creating like invisible, let's say, invisible mini H, which is very fine for fine cutting. We're gonna try to cut the hairs after. We're gonna try to cut the paper. So we're gonna see the results after the weather stop. Okay, now we're going to the green one. That's a fine. Everybody know this paste. I can see already that the edges start to be shiny. I really like the results the leather does. All right, so let's see. I don't know how to fix it so you can see it. And on the other side. Let's try on the hairs. Not sure where can you see the hairs, if you can see in here. Cut the hairs away. Alright. So if you cut the hairs, definitely gonna cut the paper. It's really nice and smooth. Very good result. I'm happy. I think my customer also gonna be happy. All right, cool. So thanks for watching. Oh, now you can see the H. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe. We'll be very glad. Write your questions. I will try to answer your questions. And yeah, see you soon. Bye bye.